Hello, I'm Marijke Engel, Principal Product Manager for Adobe Analytics. Today I want to share with you a new capability in Customer Journey Analytics called Full Table Export. You can use this feature to export large reports as concatenated tables directly from Workspace to a cloud destination of your choice. So let's say I'm doing analysis on marketing channels and how they drive purchases of products. My finance team has asked me to provide this data on a weekly basis to our Snowflake instance. With CJA Full Table Export, I can design the table and schedule it to be delivered to Snowflake weekly as a CSV file. I'm going to start by setting up my export accounts and locations utilizing the new exports component. I'm going to go to location accounts. And then before I start sending the scheduled files to the Snowflake account I've set up, I'd like to test the output more quickly. To do that, I'm going to create a new account to send data to Adobe AAP Data Landing Zone. AAP Data Landing Zone is a free Azure account available to all CJA users who have AAP access. It provides a quick temporary storage location for CJA exports. So to set up this new account, I'm going to click Add Account, name the account, add a description, and select the account type AAP Data Landing Zone. Once the account is created, I'll get a success message that includes this SAS URI. I'm going to copy this to the clipboard. And then to access the files in AAP Data Landing Zone, I need to download and install the Microsoft Azure Storage Explorer, which is a small free app that provides an easy UI for accessing Azure files. I've done that here. And now I'm going to connect my data landing zone. Push the connection key, blob container or directory, shared access, next. And here's where I'm going to paste that URI. It will automatically add a display name and I'm good to go. So push next and connect. Now in my blob containers area, I'll see that CJA export-1 folder. Inside there are all the folders related to my landing zone. So going back into CJA, you can click OK. The next step is to add a location to the account. I'm going to go to Locations, click Add Location, and AAP Landing Zone, Finance, and AAP Landing Zone. And now I'm going to create a prefix, which is a folder that will appear in Azure. I'm going to call this folder Finance because I'm going to put all of the finance test data there. And then I'm going to click Save. And now I see successfully that I've created a location. Once I have both an account and a location, I'm ready to start exporting data. Navigating back to Workspace and my report, I can right-click at the top of the table and select Export Full Table. Since I'm testing this data, I want to make it a one-time send now report. And so I'm going to name it, add tags and descriptions if I'd like, and select the date range, which I want last week's data, like that. And I'm going to keep it one time. It brought in all of the columns that I had in my original table, and I'm good with that. If I wanted, I could also add filters or additional breakdowns, and I want this to be a CSV file. So then finally, I'm going to go and select account and location. It autofills with the last ones you created, so you'll see in here AAP Landing Zone and AAP Landing Zone Finance, so I know I'm sending it to the right place. I'm going to click Save. Now that I've created the export to data landing zone, I can go into components, exports, and check the status. So here's my export definition for finance, and it shows as complete. If I go to the logs, I can see that it's also completed here, and the number of rows and some additional details. So if I go back into the Microsoft Azure Storage Explorer, I can see I have a new folder called finance. And inside Finance, I'll see my exported files. There's always going to be two files, the file containing the data and a manifest file. So if I open that file containing the data, I can inspect it in any kind of spreadsheet tool. So what I'm doing here is really just checking to make sure that the report looks like I wanted it to, contains the data that I wanted it to, before I start sending it to Snowflake. So I think this looks great. I'm going to go back into CJA and set it up to deliver weekly to Snowflake. So going back into Workspace, finding my report. Since I've already set up my Snowflake account and location, I can just set up a new project to point at that location. So I right-click, select Export Full Table, name my project, add a description if I want. And this time, because I want to set it up to be scheduled, I'm going to select a schedule. And when you select a schedule, such as weekly, you'll get slightly different options that are relevant to that schedule plan. So now I'm going to select a look back window of last week. And I'm going to set up when it starts and ends. So this always defaults to 1 year of delivery. And I want to send it once a week. And I always want to send it on Mondays. CSV format. And this time I'm going to select my Snowflake. And once I'm happy with all of the settings here, I can click Save. And now my report is set up to schedule weekly to my Snowflake account. And as the weeks go by, I can always come in to my log tab and review every file that's being delivered and whether it failed or completed successfully and monitor the progress of deliveries. So that's a quick overview of CJA's new full table export capabilities.